My name is Tim Johnson. I live in Georgetown, Ohio, and I also work in Georgetown, Ohio as a professional counselor over here in private practice. And I attend the Crosspoint Online campus. In 2006, I was married at that point to my college sweetheart. We've been married several years, and we had three children, Jacob, Courtney, and Noah. Denise was my wife. In 2006, my kids, Courtney and Noah, were diagnosed with a super rare disease called juvenile Batten's disease. It's a terminal disease, a neurological degenerative disease, where basically they would eventually go blind, they would have seizures, they would be crippled, and they would just sort of fade away. When the kids were first diagnosed, I realized that since it was a terminal disease and there was no treatment for it, that God was the only solution if the kids were going to be healed. And so there was a time where early on, when my faith really grew and I trusted the Lord and really honestly thought that He was going to heal both kids. And as time went on, it became apparent that was not going to be the case. By the time my daughter Courtney had passed away, I was really just relieved, honestly, because her condition had deteriorated so much during that time. It was really a merciful thing. And when my wife Denise was, we always kind of thought that we would see the kids through their journey, and then God would do some kind of work, and we would be doing that work together. And then she found a lump in her left breast. That was back, I think, in 2016. And the lump, it turned out, was cancer. So while she was taking the chemotherapy, the tumor mutated and it started growing faster and aggressively, and so then she passed away shortly after that. About 4 or 5 days after they had realized that, she passed away actually in front of me when we were at home together. You know, when the healing didn't come, then I got pretty mad at God, really mad at Him, and I cursed at Him. I didn't trust Him. I felt like He killed my daughter, He killed my wife, He was gonna kill my youngest son, and so I just got really consumed by anger and hurt and hopelessness and that kind of stuff. And I kind of got sunk so low that I actually kind of developed a mindset of that all I had to do was live one more day longer than my youngest son. So when he passed away, what happened to me after that was not really, it didn't really matter. And so I kind of got to that place. You know, God's a wise father, right? And so like any wise father, when your kid's having a tantrum, you just ignore them, you know? And so that's kind of what he did. He just sort of like let me have my little fit and he just kind of waited me out. And as much as you maybe, you know, when the Holy Spirit lives inside of you, you at some point you just can't help but get drawn back to your Creator. So I start talking to Him again. You know, we kind of made up, and I just start talking to Him about my brokenness and just how confused I was and lonely and isolated and all that stuff. And so He assured me how much He loved me and that was part of His plan. And He assured me that, you know, my wife and my daughter were fine. They were healed, they were in heaven, and everything was okay. And he promised me that He had plans for me that were greater than anything that I could even imagine. And so I repented because, you know, I had pride and I had anger and all those things. And so a scripture came to me and at that time that it wasn't good for man to be alone. So I I started praying for new relationships and given my situation, they were relationships that kind of had to come to me because of I'm taking care of my handicapped son still, and so of Noah. And so, um, So I started to attend the online services at Crosspoint. And then a couple weeks later, Austin reached out to me and suggested doing one of the growth groups. And so I did that, and Austin's a good guy. And so and then Steve was part of that group. And so I met Steve and then God brought another person into my life that was just an absolute perfect fit for where I was. And that person brought a lot of hope and a whole new kind of mindset to where I was. So I felt encouraged and I felt hope was restored and I felt that that my trust in God had grown exponentially during that time. So I'm actually pretty excited to see what's going to happen next. Don't know Jesus? Go find him. He's not hiding. He literally died to be in a relationship with you, because he loves you more than you have any idea how much he loves you. If you do know him already, just be honest with him. Tell him how you're feeling. He can handle it, and he will handle it. Tell him what you need. Tell him what you want. Be real with him. Then be open when opportunities present themselves to just go grab them. Sometimes you have to reach out when somebody reaches out to you. So.